According to the Assistant Commissioner in charge of Human Resource and Inspection in the Ministry of Public Service, James Luyinda, the Cabinet has today met at the State House in Entebbe to make the final decision on the arts teachers' demand.
The matter has been resolved. I think the Permanent Secretary will issue information on that. But there's something that is happening now. But I have also taken advantage of this, being also a parent, to ask, request the teachers to go back to school so that service delivery does not suffer.
Luyinda told the teachers to remain hopeful and reiterated government's commitment to seeing that its workers are well compensated but in a phased manner.
Already, the process has already started. Some have been enhanced. Teachers, be kind enough and go back, since the government is trying to do something about it.
But the teachers insist on a time frame in which their salaries will be increased.
Teachers remain at home until we get satisfactory feedback from government.
Their argument is that in 2018, they came into an agreement with the government to increase the arts teachers' salaries in a phased manner, with the highest qualified teacher to be paid 4.5 million shillings monthly, followed by 2.7 million shillings for the teachers with diplomas. Unfortunately, this has never been implemented. They now say increasing salaries of only science teachers is segregative.
A lot of anxiety and a lot of things. To some extent, the teachers of arts, humanities, are seen as less important by even their colleagues, because they are looking at themselves as more of teachers than their counterparts. And therefore, it's government's responsibility to correct this impression. Otherwise, even the learners will start questioning why they are studying arts subjects.
Report by Jaliet Namwaya for the news.